Back to the streets that paved the road. great to be back in LA. For once, I'm at a loss for words. We better just do this. Thank you for having us back. It's wonderful.
In the dark, we make a fire.
I'll tell you some secrets. I've now joined that bunch of people who are total hypochondriacs and get up every morning and wonder what the hell their voice is going to sound like. So I now know what Fred went through all those years, you know. Except he always got it right. So I may need some help on this, okay? One, two, three.
Don't you hear my call, though you're many years away? Don't you hear me calling you? Write your letters in the sand for the day I take your hand in the land that I grant children.
To introduce you to a very old friend and a fantastic keyboard player, Mr. Spike Edney.
I'm just the pieces of the man I used to be. Too many bitter tears are raining down on me. I'm far away from home, and I've been facing this alone.
Too much love will kill you every time.
you, folks. I'm happy to say. All right.
Thank you. Thank you.
someday, okay? Take care of yourselves till then.
I think it does. I think it makes you re-examine what you are and what you do, and you won't be satisfied with just doing what you did before. Yeah, it does shake you up. I think when you're in the middle of really being shaken up, you can't do much at all. I think it's a fallacy that you can sort of create wonders out of tragedy directly. I don't think many people can, because you're too busy kind of experiencing at the time. But when you come out, you've had to kind of rebuild yourself, and part of that process is comes out in your the creative side. Personally, I don't think it has, really, no. I was lucky enough not to to have pressures to make music in any way. I mean, we never had any money, but it never bothered me at all. I always had enough to eat, so that was, so I was fine. So I was never forced to think of it as a money-making thing, and I wasn't really interested in power. And what's the other motive? Thanks, Jackie. Fame and fortune, I don't think ever really meant that much. So I think I always wanted to do it because I wanted to do it, you know, and it's the same now. It's fascinating to me, that business of sort of speaking to people through music and getting a response. It's to me, a very sensitive and special kind of communication. It probably sounds very pretentious of me to say so, but if somebody comes up to me and says, this particular track you did changed my life, made me feel something, or perhaps, you know, some people have said a track stopped them from killing themselves at a particular time in their life, then that's really the best thing that can happen to me. Because I think it is, it's a kind of, it's a very uplifting kind of conversational tool, music, I think. I don't know, it's mysterious to me, I just love it. And I love the sound of it, I love the sound of the guitar. Just enjoy doing it. And to be able to get paid for standing up and doing what I want to do anyway is a dream. And I'm constantly aware that I'm one of the luckiest people alive, really, to be able to do that.